You want to learn how to turn your boring and mundane hero sections and model windows from this into this? Of course you do. And that's exactly what I'll show you in this video. We will use backdrop filter to create this beautiful Glassmorphism effect, and we will add the gradients to our button and even our headline. On top of that, we will make sure that everything works fine in browsers that still don't support, well, the properties we will be using. So let's get started. Okay, I have created a simple demo on CodePen to demonstrate this. You're gonna find the link in the description if you wanna check the finished version of the code, maybe play around with it. I have a hero section here. It can be viewed as a model window as well, or any kind of element that goes over some kind of a background, be it an image like in this example, or maybe even an interface. HTML is pretty much straightforward. I have a hero section, headline, paragraph, and a link that is styled like a button, and CSS. For CSS, I'm using Flexbox to center this element on the screen, and I'm making sure the background image covers the entirety of our available canvas. I'm using Railway font from Google Fonts for typography. Now, on CodePen, you can enable Google Fonts if you go into Settings, HTML tab, and you're gonna find Stuff for Head section here. You can add a link to your Google font you wanna use here, and you're gonna be able to use it in your CSS just like this. I have added a little bit of styling to our hero section. We have a box shadow, border radius, and stuff like that. And the thing to note is this inset shadow here is actually just one pixel line that goes around the element. It's almost white, and its purpose is to highlight this element a bit more to make it pop out. So nothing special about the headline here. I'm using the dark blue color here. And for hero text, I'm just making sure that it never goes beyond the 50 characters width, because text is most readable when it's between maybe 50 or 80, something like that, characters. On larger screens, this is going to stretch, and text will not go beyond this limit, so it's gonna be a bit more readable. Let's return this to our starting point. And lastly, we have a button here. It has a solid red color, and I'm using display block with the fit content on width to ensure that element doesn't stretch the entire width of the container, but rather just as much as it needs to based on its own content, or rather this text here. So if we comment this out, you're gonna see that the button is 100% of the container, and with this, it takes only as much space as it needs to. For the responsive side of things, I'm just reducing the font size on smaller screens, and that's pretty much it for this demo. So what we can do with this is we can improve this design quite a bit. And one thing that I would like to do first is I would like this beautiful background image that I found on Unsplash to allow a little bit more of its colors to come through this element. And we can do this if we just reduce the opacity of our background. And now the colors are coming through, but the problem is the text here becomes pretty much unreadable. We can go around this if we make this background on the element a little bit blurred. Maybe if we create some kind of a Glassmorphism effect, it's not going to interfere with our foreground so much, because those lines will not be so clear and they're not gonna mess up our readability right here. And we can actually do this if we use the backdrop filter. And the backdrop filter is a CSS property that allows you to set different kind of graphical effects to the back of our element. Now, there are numerous of graphical effects available, such as blur, contrast, brightness, and many more. I will add a link to the description to MDN resource so you can check what graphical effects are available. And for now, we will try using blur, because if we make this background a little bit blurrier, it's not gonna interfere with our text so much. So let's do backdrop filter, blur. Let's add 15 pixels of blur. And now this looks much, much better. The lines are no longer clear. The colors are still coming through. And this background looks really beautiful, while at the same time, our text remains readable. Now, one thing that I would like to do is I would like this background to be a bit brighter. And as we're already using 90% of lightness on our background color here, we can't really tweak that. But what we can do is we can add another backdrop filter, brightness, to make this background even brighter. Let's add brightness, and let's increase it by 50%. So altogether 150%. Now this looks much better, but I think it's still a little bit too much of shapes are coming through. So let's increase the blur to maybe 35 pixels. And all right, we have improved this quite a bit, I think. Now we'll just see how the brightness filter affects this. If we return to 100%, this is our initial state. And if we set it to 170%, we have this beautiful light coming from behind it, and it just makes our element shine. And the beautiful thing is that colors are coming through. It doesn't interfere with our text here, and it really connects the design, or rather our element, with the background. Next, we will add gradients to our button and to our headline. And whenever we're using colors on a prominent image like this one, we want to make sure that we use colors that are already present on the image. So I've selected red from this image from somewhere around here, and this dark blue is coming from here. So we're gonna add another blue. We're gonna pick it from right here, and we're gonna add this to our button. So let's create background image linear gradient, background image linear gradient. We're gonna create this gradient at a 45 degrees angle. We're gonna use the red color we already have as the ending point, and we're gonna go from blue to red. So we're gonna pick a blue color, and I'm using a tool called SIP. It's available here in my menu bar, and it allows me to pick any kind of color from the screen. I'm gonna add a link to this tool to description if you want to check it out. So I will pick this midnight blue color, and let's see how our button looks if we add this. And I have made a mistake here, and I will correct it right away. So there we go. And our button looks much nicer and much more interesting right now. A beautiful thing about using HSL colors is that you can tweak the key components of a color just by tweaking the numbers in code. We can tweak saturation and lightness to maybe make this blue a bit more saturated. For example, let's change saturation to 75, and maybe darkness, make it a little bit lighter. And all right, this looks pretty okay. And now we have this beautiful gradient color on our button. Next thing we will probably want to do is we will want to add some kind of a hover effect. And for this button, I'm thinking if we just increase the lightness of our colors, and we can do this by tweaking those values, we are going to make button seem like it lights up when you hover over it, and it's going to really invite those clicks, which you always want to do when you have a button like this that is basically a call to action button. So let's add a hover state to our selector hero button here. As I'm using sass here, I can nest my selector, or rather my hover state, directly here using the ampersand selector and sass, which is going to compile into hero button hover. And I can just copy my rule from here and tweak the lightness by maybe 10%, maybe make it 40 and 55. Let's see how this looks. And this looks pretty good. And obviously this is just jumping from one state to another. Not ideal. We would want maybe this button to be animated, to go from initial state to our hover state. And we would probably want to do this by using transition, all properties, just for the example, and 0.2 seconds with the ease in out transition function. Let's see how this works. And it doesn't. And it doesn't work because background image is not an animatable property in CSS. Browser doesn't know how to animate from the initial background image to, well, the hover background image. But the thing that we did here is we just tweaked the lightness of our color. And we already did a similar thing like this on our hero element with the backdrop filter. We increased the brightness of our background. Luckily, there's another filter that we can use in CSS, which is conveniently called filter. And the difference between filter and backdrop filter is that backdrop filter applies the graphical effect brightness, in our case, to the background of the element, while the filter applies it to the entire element. So we're gonna add a filter rule to our hover selector instead of this background image, and increase the brightness by 20%. Filter is transitionable and animatable property in CSS, so everything should work as we would expect, and it does. Our button really lights up, and this looks and works beautifully. One thing to note when you're doing something like this is always make sure that your hover state also is accessible. I'm using the white color, so increasing the brightness will not affect my text here. If I were to use some kind of different color, it might have some kind of effect on it, and I want to make sure that text always remains readable. All right, we're going to add the same background to our title here. So I'm just going to copy our background gradient we created, and just for the fun, we will switch the colors in the gradient to go from red to blue to make it a bit more interesting. And right now the background is applied to, well, to the background of our headline. What we want to do instead, we want to apply the background only to our text. And we can do that by specifying background clip property. And background clip property allows you to define the way the background is applied to your element. It can be applied to a border of the element, to padding of the element, content, or just to the text of the element. And that's what we're gonna do here. We're just gonna apply it to the text. Background clip. And we're gonna do text. And this now appears that it's not working, but what happens here is background is applied only to the shape of our letters, but we still have this foreground color defined here, this dark blue, which goes above our background. And that means that gradient is just not visible because of this color. If we were to change the opacity of this, you're gonna see that gradient is coming true. And what we can do here is we can just add a completely transparent color here to allow our entire gradient to shine through. And another thing, we can tweak colors here as well because we're using this HSL format, and I would like this red to be a bit darker, a bit more saturated maybe, maybe even more. And well, blue looks pretty much okay. Maybe let's make it a bit lighter. And yeah, this works pretty fine. With just a few simple rules, we really improved on our initial design here. Now the background here features this beautiful gradient, allows our colors from our background image to shine through, doesn't interfere with our content, and we've added these beautiful effects to our button and to our headline. It just works and looks really, really well. But we have created a bit of a problem here. And the problem is that the backdrop filter is not supported in all browsers. It's not supported in Firefox at the moment. So in Firefox, our design is going to look something like this. And I'm not gonna be opening this example in Firefox now. I'm just gonna demonstrate by commenting out the backdrop filter rule, because that's exactly what the Firefox will render. And now the problem is our text has become unreadable because we tweaked the background opacity because of this backdrop filter rule. So ideally, we just wanna apply our semi-transparent background and our backdrop filter if the browser supports backdrop filter. And we can do this if we use supports at rule. And supports at rule allows us to test the browser support for any property and value combination. So we can just copy our entire selector here and test if the browser supports backdrop filter with those kind of values. And if it does, we can apply rules we have here to our design. And I'm gonna return this to the initial value of 90% of opacity. So this is our starting point. And if the browser supports backdrop filter, we're gonna apply backdrop filter and the semi-transparent background, which will result in something like this. So what we did here is we enhanced our design for the browsers that support backdrop filter, but the browsers that don't support it are still gonna work fine, even though they don't look as good. So Firefox will see a design like this, and in Chrome, we will see something like this. We can apply the same logic to our background clip property. Now, fortunately, background clip is supported in all modern browsers, but it's not supported in Internet Explorer. If somebody, for some reason, visits your site or this demo in Internet Explorer, and we want to make sure that they actually can read the title, we will have to apply the same logic to this property as well, because this is what's going to happen if the browser doesn't support background clip. And this is obviously really bad. And what's happening here is we set the color to transparent, but the background is not applied just to our text, but to the entire element. So the text or headline becomes completely unreadable. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna use supports at rule again. We're gonna test if the browser supports background clip with the value text. And if it does, we're gonna apply to the exactly the same selector rules we created specifically for our background clip. This is gonna be transparent color, linear gradient, and background clip rules. So let's see how this works. Okay, so in Chrome, we're gonna have result like we had before, and in browsers that don't support background clip, we're gonna have a version that looks like this, which is just a dark blue color that can be read perfectly, but may not look as good. Important thing is that everybody can access our site, our design, and everybody can actually read our content. So with just those few simple tweaks, we have really improved our initial design. We've allowed a lot more of color and a lot more of light to come through our background image, which makes for this really interesting effect on our element. We've added this beautiful gradient to our headline and to our button, and we've even animated this gradient background on our button. So when you hover over it, it lights up and really invites you to click that call to action button. So I hope you found this helpful. I hope you learned something. And if you don't want to miss my future videos, and I will be releasing them frequently, weekly, make sure to hit that subscribe button. My name is Zoran Jambor. Thank you for your attention. I will see and hear you in the next video.